With that, let's get up to Bank of America Stadium in Charlotte. Here are Brandon Guy and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Carolina Panthers. Hi again, everyone. I'm Brandon Gordon. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. With me, as always, Charles Davis. And, Charles, we look at a matchup like this. It's really the running backs that may take center stage here today.
And in today's football, they're still valuable, not just as runners, but guys who can catch the ball as well. It's really the number of touches that determines things these days.
The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And off we go from uptown Charlotte. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now a carry for the former Michigan State man, Le'Veon Bell. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. Again, it's Bell. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7. And the starting crew defensively for Carolina.
Charles Johnson off the edge. A long day for any offensive tackle.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. On 3rd down, Roethlisberger. And James has it. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
And the game just keeps evolving.
Oh, that's bad.
Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
So here we go, 1st and 10 now. Now Roethlisberger on 1st down. And it's complete to Ladarius Green. A good pick up there of 20 yards. You know, when I see passes like that, I'm reminded of something you and I talked about yesterday. Big Ben was a wide receiver the first 3 years of high school, sitting behind the coach's son. And then he finally got that opportunity. I think he's made the most of it.
It's always the coach's son, isn't it? But you know where it helps him? When he looks downfield, he knows what the receivers are going to do. He actually has wide receivers' eyes when he's throwing the ball.
12 yards on the pickup, and that'll be good for a Pittsburgh first. And they're getting him involved early.
You feel like they saw something on tape, or they just have a sense with him because he's had a good week of practice or something in that area, that they want him involved, just as you said. They want him to touch it either in the running game or
opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Now a carry for the longtime Panther. It's D'Angelo Williams. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be 2nd down.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8.
Sadly. You've been gone for like 5 hours. What were you doing, making out with Janet?
This is 3rd down.
Wait, what's going on?
instant to get it back. Because this is a quarterback.
Okay,
ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. You're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And Boswell's kick is good. And the Steelers will jump out to a 3-0 lead. So it's our visitors who make the first dent in the scoreboard as they get three here on the initial drive of the ball game.
Yeah, it's hard to say who actually won that opening drive. On the one hand, anytime you come in as a road team and get an early lead, you're going to be thrilled. But at the same time, have the ball as deep in enemy territory as they did and come away with only three, that's got to be a little bit of a disappointment. Settle for three. But you gotta like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blow is the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side,
maybe a little gas,
yeah, a little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting upfield and only giving up three. They don't exactly feel like they've handled the offense.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. This is Bell on the dump ball. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now a first down carry by Bell. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. Back now as I search for my cue card here. There we go. Coming up at halftime, Larry Littlefield will join us from Orlando. He'll have highlights and analysis from our first half of play. Thank you. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger.
She don't understand your language.
And this is going to be incomplete. He was looking to hit his running back, Le'Veon Bell, that time. And that brings up fourth down.
And there's a good opportunity to just want to ride there.
So why are you coming to that?
I guess that's why they call them running backs and not catching backs.
You mumbled. I must have been a request to Ashley Paul to join. Why are you leaving? I request
on now the Steelers' second-year punter. This is Australian-born Jordan Berry. Back deep for the Panthers, Ted Ginn. Now this is fielded in the end zone. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Panthers will have a first and 10 from deep in their own territory.
Did Ashley join again? Do you know what to say back when she left? Yeah, Ashley joined back. That's what Ashley speaks.
Carolina getting set to take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter.
Fighting to get back to the goal line. I don't think he got there. He did not. Did not get back there. It's a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt. And if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
The Steelers offense now, they head back onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And the offense moving quickly to the line.
Huh?
On second down, Roethlisberger.
Why
finding time.
Wait,
over the middle, it's caught by Rodgers. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Brown, the wide receiver, left.
What are they doing?
Now it's Roethlisberger. And he fires one that's intercepted. And some space here. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six.
Why not?
On first down, Newton.
Can you tell me
first down? completion. Charles gives me a chance to put you on the clock real quick. NFC teams last year that did not make the playoffs that might make a push this coming year.
Well, three that come to mind right away that we thought were going to be in 2016. Minnesota, remember the start they got off to before that didn't work out so well for them. Arizona, we thought they were locked to be in the playoffs. In fact, many of us called them Super Bowl contenders. And Carolina, the defending NFC champs going into last season, they didn't make it. So I think that all three could return to former glory. I'm going to give you one way off the pace here. You ready?
Let's go.
The Los Angeles Rams. Ooh. They get the young quarterback going and that defense continues to live up to expectations. They can make a real strong push in the West.
They've got the D. You're right. They just need the O. Stephon Tuitt in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback, because he had no chance to block him.
Stewart is the lone setback. They go play action with Stewart. Now Newton. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds. Incomplete. Greg Olsen was the intended target, and it's third down. Good job by the O-line. Quarterback had time to go through his checks. That's one you need to take advantage of.
A perfect situation, and they're unable to take advantage of it. When you have that much time to scan the field, you have to find an open receiver. The Steelers insert their nickel defense on third down.
Yeah, they add a DB. To throw is Newton. He's going to go up top again. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now, in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot.
Well, they've clearly made a conscious decision here to be more aggressive in the late stages of this game here in the second half.
And I get it. In this situation, you know, if you want to... your defense maybe, or just, hey, I thought I had a proper play call, but how about the guys that just stopped them? How good do they feel right now? Hey, you want to go for it here? We shut you down? They're over on the bench right now feeling great.
And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to. To be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. That's caught at the 3. A good pickup there, 8 yards on the first down completion.
What would you have said to me if I told you pregame that Big Ben and Antonio Brown wouldn't have hooked up until the second half?
I would say that they'd be losing, and they are.
Yeah, they are, and they've got to find a way now to continue to connect and try and get their team back in this game.
They'll try and run it in with Bell, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. Le'Veon Bell taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Steelers have now made this a one-score game. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Take this one only up to about the 21. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
It's a loss of two. Now third down.
To me, that's a superior play by the backer, because he was allowed to, I think, run free on it and make that play. His defensive linemen, they covered things down for him, because offensive guys, the linemen, what they're trying to do, as you know, is block the guy at the point of attack and then climb to the next level and get the linebacker. And you're not allowed to climb. You got a free hitter, and that's what we saw there. And a really nice play resulted for them.
He was trying to get it that time to Ted Ginn. And fourth down coming up.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And Cam Newton's not coming off the field. He'll keep the offense out to go for it on fourth. They come out here in the eye. Newton now to throw. He sets to fight and got his man complete. And they finally get him, but not before he reaches the 33-yard line.
We know it's tough enough to pick up first downs on third down plays, but when you go for it on fourth down, sometimes you're actually just praying, and on that play, the prayer was answered.
And we're back now in Charlotte. It's been a good one so far, just a two-point game here as we get set for quarter number four. Now Stewart on first down. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains.
How many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways. In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
They keep it on the ground again to Stewart, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And a good run as he manages 7 yards down to the 17.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play. But forget knowing where the first down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They had more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
They're going to run. This is Stewart. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. That one good for 10 yards. And the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal.
It's 4th and 2, and you know the defense is going to stack the line of scrimmage. So you have to be definite about your decision about where to go.
They come out here in the eye. Trying to punch it in, Stewart. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Jonathan Stewart, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Panthers add on to their lead. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the numbers. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. The bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
So that drive goes a full 80 yards in 10 plays. And it's capped off by a Jonathan Stewart run. throwing the touchdown here to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no thought to bring this one out. He'll just go down to a knee, and they'll take over at the 25. The Panthers defense gearing up as they take the field. And they gave up a touchdown last drive. You kind of need to hit the reset button after every touchdown given up, Charles.
I love that. And the way that you phrased it is perfect, because from series to series, you can reset how the game is going to go. If you gave up a touchdown before, it doesn't mean you have to do it again. And if you made a great play before, you have to reset again anyway, because they're going to attack. So I love the way you phrased it and put it out there. That's what they have to do in this series.
Not like when you're playing a video game. You can't hit the reset button here. Let's go.
No, you shouldn't anyway, that's for sure. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Again on second and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So the Steelers with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. On third down, Roethlisberger. He's got time in the pocket. He's going to let it fly. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way down to the 22-yard line. It's a big play. Roethlisberger to Brown. 53 yards. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Here's Roethlisberger surveying the field. Still back there. Oh, no, he lost the football. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. The 30. And that should just about do it. They return it to the end zone, sealing it with a defensive touchdown. The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that. That's what they've done all game long.
And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion. Newton turns and hands to Stewart. And he's going to go down right at the line of scrimmage. The defense left him with nowhere to go, and the try for two is denied. So not only the cough up, but then the pickup on the other side, the scoop, and the score the other way. The fumble return for a touchdown. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Roethlisberger on first down, throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Second and 10 now, it's Roethlisberger to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. And right now, defensively, you love that, don't you? I mean, you'll give them that play.
And they'll take it every single time. This is almost like nickeling and diming it downfield, and too much time's going to run off the clock.
A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and 8. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. He's got a man complete. And that one results in 35 yards. And now they're in the hurry-up. On first and 10, it's Roethlisberger. Man open right side, it's Rodgers. A gain of six there on first. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They go play action here on first down. He's got time. And he overshot in there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Second and 10. It's Roethlisberger once more. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and 4. To throw again is Roethlisberger. And that one drops to the ground. Incomplete. Clock stops here just inside of 20 seconds. 19 left. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Here we go. It's Roethlisberger on fourth down. Goes underneath for Bell. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Le'Veon Bell. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit.
And there's the touchdown that they needed, so they'll celebrate. But the guys on the sidelines, they've got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert and get that onside kick. That time, a 9-play drive. And it ends with a Le'Veon Bell touchdown run. Oh, and I think they got it. Yes, the Steelers have it. So they've accomplished half the mission, Charles. They get the onside kick. They do need a touchdown here, but they've got some time to do it.
In the excitement, there's no need to press. Plenty of time. They have the opportunity. Now they just need to execute and finalize things.
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
Well, they needed the touchdown and the two-point conversion, but they're not going to get a shot at either. This is a great play here defensively, Brandon, and at a time that they sorely needed one. And that could be enough to help get them out of here with a victory.
Here's Stewart. And the Steelers signal for another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. They'll try a little trickery here on the end around. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. This is Whitaker. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.